Loving Father, as we prepare in these days for the coming of Jesus, your Son, we surrender to you the darkness in our lives and wait in expectant hope. Father,
may your kingdom grow harvest.
You promise that light will shine in darkness, light in our hearts a flame of your love that will bring healing in life. Father,
may your kingdom grow in our midst.
Father, we bring before you for God's kingdom to grow in the words Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Thank you. Christ's birth and kingdom are foretold by Isaiah. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. On the inhabitants of the country, in shadow dark of death, light has blazed forth, for a son has been born for us, a son has been given to us, and dominion has been laid on his shoulders. And this is the name he has been given, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace, to extend his dominion in boundless peace over the throne of David, and his kingdom to make it secure and sustain it, in fair judgment and integrity, from this time onwards and forever. The jealous love of the Lord God will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. and the angel left them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
were shepherds out in the fields, keeping guard over their sheep during the watches of the night. An angel of the Lord stood over them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified, but the angel said, "Do not be afraid. Look, I bring you news of great joy, a joy to be shared by the whole people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord, and here is a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And all at once, with the angel, there was a great throng of the hosts of heaven, praising God with the words, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and on earth peace for those who favor us." Now it happened that when the angels had gone from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this event which the Lord has made known to us." So they hurried away and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
They saw the child with his mother Mary, and falling to their knees, they did him homage.
Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. John records the great mystery of incarnation. In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things came into being. Not one thing came into being except through him. What has come into being in him was life. Life that was the light, and light shines in the darkness, and darkness could not overpower it. A man came, sent by God. His name was John. He came as a witness to bear witness to the light, so that everyone might believe through him. He was not the light, he was to bear witness to the light. The Word was the real light that gives light to everyone. He was coming into the world, he was in the world that had come into being through him, and the world did not recognize him. He came to his own, and his own people did not accept him. But all that did accept him, he gave power to become children of God, to those who believed in his name, who were born not from human stock or human desire, or human will, but through God himself. The Word became flesh, he lived among us, and we saw his glory, the glory that he has from the Father, full of grace and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.